Hi everybody, welcome back to XCOM. I heard your cries last episode, sorry. I apparently, by total mistake, I replaced Can's PCS with the agility instead of his Psy one. I obviously didn't mean to do that, I'm very sorry about that. And so what I did was I loaded up my last save from when I did the last mission. And then I just kind of redid it up until this part. There is a couple of differences, which is kind of weird. Apparently, I got like 5 cores. I'm pretty sure I looked at it. Like, here, one sec, choose project. So I'm doing advanced explosives right now because I decided to do one of these. I have 4 cores. I'm pretty sure this was not the case when I started this, when I did this last time, which is really, 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 really weird. And I tried to kind of repeat the same things. I was doing Psionic Gate, even though I think I want to finish autopsies, actually, just to see what they do, because I think we're in endgame now. Yeah, so that was odd. So everything's relatively the same, except I haven't yet equipped the PCS bonuses. Also, this mission is slightly in a different place. But it's relatively the same thing, just sective pod heavy mech. Reduces retaliation counter by 2 weeks, and then there's the 2 hidden events that I'm not just gonna ignore. Even though that's probably a terrible idea, because it could be something super bad. But, you know, that's the game we play. Okay, so we got stealth here. I'm gonna give stealth the flashbang, and Kyle the armor, just because I just want him using the pistol all the time. Oh yes, and because I didn't yet do the personal combat sims, here we go. One second. What does she have right now? Oh, no, it's just telling me it can't be replaced, okay. The mobility. Yes. There you go. So now she has got advanced speed. I don't know who I'm going to give dodge to. I don't even think I'm going to give that to anybody right now, because I think Kyle wants some aim, and I don't know. Yeah, you went, sure. Kyle can be agility. I don't care. This is like a super dodge, dude. It's like crazy. But yeah, we'll give it to Kyle just because, yeah. He's always in the front lines kind of a thing. Well, not always, but yeah, you get the idea. There's something I want to show you here. Yeah, I'm going to try and still level up Mr. Shiv and who else? And Adam. I think that's all the people that aren't Colonel right now. Well, Ken levels up through his own way and means. The thing I want to show you guys was this. This is the stupidest thing on the planet. So I got Plasma Grenade. Look at the damage. So it's 5 to 6. The range and radius and stuff don't really worry about it. It's relatively the same for the EMP Grenade. But I get Shred 2 on this. On the EMP Grenade, I don't get Shred, but it's like a high roll of the damage. Like, why is this, why is the EMP grenade that I just researched so crappy? This is actually why I decided to go and research advanced explosives, because I think that unlocks something that's better. Because, as far as I'm concerned, I have no reason to bring EMP grenades along. And I've heard smokes are bugged and actually don't give you any defense bonuses, but that may be wrong now. And also, let's give, this guy Shredagun. No. Shredagun goes to Adam. Sorry, because that's a not explosive thing. Okay, so that's pretty much our plan right now, guys. So, we got to destroy the alien relay. I think last time it was hacked to some terminal or something, so now the mission has even changed, which is weird, so whatever. Let's go. The things I do, just so Ken keeps his sigh. The things I do.
Sky Ranger deployed.
We're in the pipe, 5x5.
Shen came across an odd series of transmissions coming out of this region, and we've narrowed it down to a hidden alien communications relay transmitting to the Advent network. We can't pass up any opportunities to disrupt their progress on the latest operation, so we're moving in to take out that relay. Neutralize any hostile contacts near the site, lock it down, and destroy the target.
You know, it's kind of disturbing that I got so many cores after that mission, even though I don't think I got any when I did the last time.
And the communications relay is up ahead. Move in and destroy the target.
That should actually be pretty easy. Where's stealth? Alright, let's have a look at what's going on over here. Let's go over here. All right.
We've got a hostile squad here.
That's a lot of guys. Here's the problem. I don't think we can kill zone this because they're in such an awkward place. Like, holy crap. Well, let's pretend like we're that's what we're gonna do. I'm pretty sure, yeah, we got side on one, but it's like, oh, geez. We could not have asked for a worse start here, to be perfectly honest. Alright. I guess Adam's gonna go down here. I'm not allowed to move someone else right now, apparently. Oh, dude, someone has like a chair. Some people have chairs up here. Yeah, we know they're there, Adam. Don't pretend you're special. That's like the perfect grenade opportunity, though, I have to say.
Okay, we move.
Let's see. And Cand will go, I guess, over here somewhere. Oh, dude, I could also void rift that, though. Overwatch, ever vigilant, because he used all his things on moves. Where are they going? That's not good. Oh no, they went a little bit up there, actually. That's actually not awful. Okay, so we're gonna move, I think. I don't wanna really move all the way up there with stealth just yet, so we're gonna move over here with him first. Oh, they spotted me. Shit. Yeah, it's a good thing I didn't move stealth there. That's all I can say. Is he gonna be retarded enough to move up here? Oh, yeah, he sees me too. Alright. I think what we're gonna do is we're gonna just move back, I think. And I'm gonna killzone this as well. Because I don't really see a reason not to killzone this. Because I think they're retarded enough to just walk into our Overwatch, so... We might just go back here. How much can... Okay, so from this position... Yeah, okay, so stealth is okay. I think stealth is gonna move over here.
Confirmed.
Let's see. What is Adam's movement options? Let's have a look. I think if stealth kind of moves a little bit over here, I think we'll be okay. So the reason why we're doing this is so that Adam can move back as far as possible, which is, looks like it's gonna be super difficult to do. See, here's the question: do I want to go here, or do I want to get possibly flanked over here? Is the question, because I'm pretty sure they can't shoot me, but they could come up here and try and get a shot off. But it's possible that let's see if anybody can see him if he's up here. Looks like he looks fine. All right, so before we move, Kyle's gonna take a shot. This is Kyle, right? I'm shooting. Yeah, it is Kyle. Because I wanna do proper Overwatch with myself. Let's see. The Elite Lancer, maybe. Heavy Mech could also take a shot. It's a matter of either the Heavy Mech or this Elite Lancer. And we're gonna go with the Elite Lancer just because he's gonna actually sword the hell out of somebody, so. Alright, so Kyle took a nice shot. And so, with myself, I will killzone over. I have to get like a weird angle where I can get them if they move up the middle. It's like, this is why I need to do this. Because the three things is, I don't want them coming up on the roof, and I don't want them coming through the alleyway. So that one looks pretty good. So we're gonna move back here. Mr. Shiv's gonna overwatch. I don't know who can see him, but that's really bad. Actually, I could avoid rift somewhere. That's fine though. We'll just leave it be. Let's have a look at what happens here now. Oh, Kyle can get shot from there. They somehow knew. I think Kyle's okay. Kyle has like max dodge though. I know, he's marked. He's like, what the fuck you just do to me? Oh, he missed anyways. Oh, dude, he set something on fire, though.
I got nothing.
Oh, wait, does it... What the hell? Alright. Alright. Come on, guys. What is this? What? Was there not something here beforehand? Why is there a perfect square here? Okay, so our cover just kind of disappeared, I think.
Willst du noch mehr?
And made a perfect hole. Well, thank God for Killzone, that's all I have to say. And Adam's getting a shot again. Like, what the hell is this? Someone must have shot there, but no, they took a shot through the ceiling, through the floor. Alright, you know what, guys? You know what, guys? We're fucking... yeah, Adam just gets killed outright because the game doesn't know what the hell bleed out is. We're gonna load this. I'm sorry. That's like... what? Why the hell did that thing just disappear? Like, it didn't really illustrate to me that that thing was shot down or something. Or maybe it did, but... like, it left like a perfect hole there, so it started making me believe that it... oh, great. This is before I even went over here. I feel like I don't want to cheese it so much just because I know they reveal me here. But... like, that's like super bad, what that did. Like, I know they can see me here, but... like, the wall disappeared here, which I thought was shot down, but the fact that that piece of cover just completely disappeared. Like, it's really difficult to, like, be, like, tactical when things like that happen. Like, if that was my fault, if this thing was shot or something, at least illustrate to me that's what happened, because I have absolutely no idea. I'm gonna just do the same thing, by the way. I'm gonna do relatively the same thing. I think the only other thing I'm gonna mix up is, I'm gonna make Adam go back here, and then I'm gonna aid protocol him. Now, come the hell on.
Moving.
Let's see. Maybe I'll void rift down there or something. I can't see anybody anyways.
Scanning.
Body guardia.
Got it covered.
Oh yes, and kill zone. Right, guys, I don't like cheesing stuff, but that's kind of bullshit what happened here. I as I said, maybe I just wasn't paying attention to it. That's very possible that happened, but yeah. You know, I don't know. I'm not losing Adam over that. I'm gonna say that. And he gets to return fire, I think. Yeah, he's got return fire with his pistol. Wait. Something disappeared again here. Now we see a black screen. Yeah, it just disappeared again. What in the fuck is going on? Yeah, the entire fucking floor is gone. What? Guys, the map is disappearing.
Alien neutralizado.
Okay, so I'm not just imagining things. It went to like this black screen where like, I don't know. Dude, I think the admins are changing something in the Matrix. I'm gonna just... this mission's fucked to hell. I'm just gonna say that now. And this guy's invisible. What in the everlasting hell went on with this mission? Dude, let's get off this damn rooftop. I'm just gonna say... wait, okay. Can I theorycraft, guys, on what maybe happened here? I think that the AI was trying to grenade up here because I had a bunch of people here. Because that's what they just did. But the game kind of pre-assumed it was going to do that. And then, like, everything got fucked, so... I know I've been trying not to swear, but in this case, can you really blame me? Like, what in the everlasting hell is going on right now is my question. At least we're on the floor, okay? At least we're on the floor now. So that, like, you know, things are not that bad right now.
Me muevo a la posición.
Let's just get sight over here. Alright, we got elite officer and this guy. I might just silence these assholes. Oh my goodness. This has been one of the worst missions I've ever done in this game. Let's do a null lance. I can't actually hit them both. Maybe I'll just set off one of their grenades. I set off his grenade. This is definitely one of the worst missions I've ever done. And now everything's on fire. Like, I'm trying not to assume anything, but yeah. Alright, here's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try and hack that guy.
Because
now we can see him for some reason.
Control attivo.
Alright, I would like to just hack him outright, if Mr. Shiv will. I think, did I get the gremlins again? The gremlin Mark 3s? Because I'm pretty sure I got that as research, but I may not have bought it. I want to take it over. Of course I can't do that. This game's an ass. We will not be working with this game again. Alright. That grenade was really nice, though. Alright, so we got Adam. What does Adam have? Does he have, like, a grenade which can hit all of them? Okay, I can kill, like... Here's what I can do. I can do this one, and I can kind of hit two of them. And shave off that guy's armor. Alternatively, my sniper has a shot, which is pretty good. But I would like to shave off his armor, though. And I'm gonna say, yes, we're gonna throw a grenade in there. We're not really throwing him, though. I noticed how... Yeah, okay, whatever. Nothing. I was gonna say something, but... At this point, yeah. Alright, that shreds some of his armor. And that takes out one of the guys, so let's see. I should take his ass out. Alright, that... Oh, I got a crit on top of that, so that's kind of nice. Alright. This has been literally one of the worst missions we've ever done. Alright, here's what we're gonna do. We're gonna go down here.
I'm going.
Just because I can lightning hands him and then pistol him, I think. And if not, like, I can just get stealth to shoot. There we go. Actually, I can lightning hands and then do fanfire, actually. I kind of like saving my fanfire up for something, but the next shot might not actually be a high... might not be a high roll, so... That's the question is... Oh, wait, no. It says 3-6, and he's got a lot of health left. Yeah, we gotta use a full thing here. Alright, yeah, too fast for you. Well, you know, the first shot was a kill. But, you know, it's better this way, guys.
Not too shabby.
I'm on it.
Well then. That was stupid. I don't think I should be doing this right now, but I like to live life on the edge. I'll probably leave it at that. Yeah, here's the thing. I was supposed to have a sectopod. I shouldn't have made stealth just kind of stay here. I should have moved her up.
Running.
She's supposed to be my stealth soldier. We have 5 turns to take off that data transfer. Adam can move up, though. Alright, what's Adam see? Eagle Eye Adam. I think we're good here. Alright, we're gonna just kind of run everyone up here.
Got it.
Just kind of make sure nothing else is here. Like, it would really suck if, like, a sectopod showed up right now, so... We're gonna try to avoid a situation where that happens. And Canned will come up somewhere. Probably not in the fire. Probably behind the rock here. I certainly hope I have no need to ask twice, Kent. This has so far been a very strange mission. Alright. Let's move stealth up here somewhere. We're gonna start with over
moving
here.
To designated coordinates.
Looks clear. I'm thinking we just blow a hole in that place.
Objective located.
Okay, we can see it now. Thing is, we have no like squad sight over that, so let's move everybody kind of as close as humanly possible. Like, I'm just gonna blow a hole basically in this part of the wall, and then we can all take shots at it
in
one turn. Also, we still have a free reload, so it's really not worth us for us to reload my sniper just quite as of yet, because it's like it's a free reload. I can do it anytime I want. What the heck can I hack? Ah, sure, let's do it. I don't see the problem with this. This mission has gone swimmingly so far. That's a new glitch, by the way. I've never encountered that before. So what do we want? We want to go for the large cache, obviously. Or wait, no, we don't want a failed hack, actually, so screw this. Oh, of course, the one time I don't do it, it's gonna fucking give me the cache of alien alloys. It's a sad story for me. Alright, and Karen will kind of, I guess, just move up to this part.
Stepping off. In position.
Alright.
The alien transmission is still active and we're running out of time. Get to the relay and take it out, ASAP.
Now we can totally see a whole bunch of stuff in there, but yeah. Alright. Let's rearrange some architecture, guys. I want to get as much as I can as possible over here. Adam's behind here, so it should still be pretty good. It should give my sniper sight lines on the guy, so... What the hell? Why did something blow up over here? Oh, I think it just, like, blew up all the way over there. What the hell? Weird. Alright, so we got some guys here. I guess I should probably take them out first. Oops, I did not do that. I just committed to that action. Oh well. Do they care? No, they don't. That's actually hilarious. A whole new meaning to stealth right now. The terminal literally just blew up around them and they don't give a crap.
Menace 1-5, we've confirmed destruction of the relay. The alien transmission is down. Eliminate any remaining hostiles and move to evac.
Moving to Overwatch.
Overwatch.
And, yep. Why did everyone take damage here? Wait, I just realized this. Oh, because they were hit by the grenade, that's right. He doesn't have restoration. Who the hell is this guy? I think he's wondering where the rest of that roof went. Oh, there's a sectopod. He's immune? Immune to what? Oh, fire. You know, this looks like it's gonna be pretty difficult to deal with. We have a lot of Overwatches, though. I mean, this is a shit ton of guys that are just kind of barreling down at me right now.
Hit the armor.
But I think we got this, guys. I think we got this. Alright. Adam, you need to be the hero. That's the kind of grenade we need right now. That's the last grenade, by the way. Like that sectopod just goes left. Alright. Now, if Fan fires up, which it is, we can definitely just shoot that sectopod in the butt. Let me just make sure we have enough range for this stuff. Okay. Cannon's gonna move up slightly. Stealth will not go anywhere until I want her to go somewhere. Question, where's my move her up? Yeah, we're gonna go up here. I might actually try and dominate someone. Let's see. Just to bring someone outside of the mix. Let's see. 66% is not a very good chance. This guy's got a 891%, so that could be good. We're leaving that open. Alright. So, we have a little bit of a problem here. Which is that Kyle can't actually shoot the Sectopod without exposing himself. Which actually is an issue. I thought he had a better angle than that. But I kind of need him to do this. So we may actually just aid protocol him. Looks like that's what we're gonna have to do. Alright, let's see. Vanfire. Look at that. This is Kyle Katarn, Sectopod killer. Or not. Not a Sectopod killer. Deflection. Pack defense decreased. Wait. I should have aid protocoled him first. Actually, wait. I think I can just send it back before I commit to this. Actually. Fuck. It's at 31. No, this isn't worth it. I'm canceling the hack so I can aid protocol him instead. I think that the action doesn't count. Does it not? Okay, good, doesn't. Okay, we're gonna aid protocol first on Kyle. Because he's getting flanked. Don't worry, guys, I have a plan. Mike Lott always has a plan. Probably to throw a flashbang, actually. No, because I have my sniper. My sniper is good for killing actually a whole bunch of them. So who else can be haywire protocol? This is the only one. It doesn't seem worth it, though, because it's like, it's a one in a million, guys. It's a one in a million chance, man. Alright. I want to take the guaranteed people out of this, so we're going to get the shield bearer. Because he's like, he's an easy target for them to go get pissed at, so there's that. Let's have a look here. Stealth is still here. Stealth can definitely kill someone, though. Alright, let's do some cereal now. Wow, that is not even a guaranteed shot. That's a really bad shot. I have to deadeye this, actually. I mean, it's like, yeah. I mean, that's a guaranteed shot, basically. Who the hell is that? That doesn't actually tell me who I'm shooting at. I assume it's this guy. Because I see Civi there. So it's like, why? Alright, that's our first one. Alright, reload. It's a free reload. I thought Kyle would do much more against the Sectopod, apparently not. It's still really nice for him to have that EMP around, so he could do this. Alright, that deals with him. Okay, I think we're gonna kill zone this now. Except this is not even a good kill zone angle, so I'm gonna change my mind maybe. Or maybe not actually. Let's go here. Even though she can kill zone, she needs to move anyways. And we're gonna double shot this guy. Didn't even need the second shot, guys.
Who's keeping score?
Alright, she has implacable, but I think we're just gonna keep her there. Alright, Mr. Shiv is probably gonna just overwatch.
Tengo pronto.
Stealth is gonna stay there, and we're gonna kill zone this guy.
An mir kommt niemand vorbei.
And end turn. Alright, that went pretty well. That is a faceless. But that's actually not a big deal, because we have kill zone up. I'm glad I took him over, because he's like, he's just going to distract them. He's like in no cover or anything in, relative to them, so they get very mad at this kind of stuff. Ten damage. Two, but that's okay.
Nemico ancora vivo.
Now that guy has the lowest defense though, but I don't know, we'll see what happens here. Blazing Pistons is what he decided to do. Okay. Sometimes I wish this game was bug free. Yeah, I saw that coming. Alright, let's see what we can do here. So, weirdly enough, Mr. Shiv is not actually under the effects of that. Maybe that guy's a really easy kill, so let's just leave him in the open for now. We need to deal with that guy. I think Adam is out of rockets, but Candace not. So, here's the thing. I think most of this like ends my turn. Yeah, it's like action ends turn, sanity action ends turn, fuse action ends turn, all land. Okay, I'm not even gonna bother. All right, so we have a rocket. We're gonna rocket him. He's not under the effects of his little build, that little guy's ability. So what I'm also gonna do, I'm gonna move this guy on the open here. Right here, if the game would kind of like let me. There we go. And we're gonna use energy shield. That's the one thing you can do for my guys. Although now that I think about it, Katarn could have probably moved in there somewhere. Alright, let's have another look around here. Okay, Adam needs to, I think, move probably over here. Because I think he only has demolition. That's a good shot. Kind of saving my sniper shot, because you never know.
Blanco eliminado.
Alright, now we gotta deal with this guy.
Me quedo sin munición en el arma.
Whatever you say.
I can't keep him here. Actually, I think that counts as a robot. That's why his pistol does so much damn damage. Yeah, it would be at this point. Because, yeah, hack defense removed. It is a robot, because it's a machine now. There's nothing piloting it anymore. Alright. I don't know. Is there someone else that needs a level?
You know that was good.
I guess Mr. Shiv kind of does. I gotta just make sure he can shoot there, but I can't actually make him make sure he can, because I can't actually see him from his camera angle. Alright, do your best. Actually, I think even if he misses, he still gets it. Or, no, he had 3 life. Is there anyone else? No, it's just me. This is the most awkward sniper shot ever. I'm not even looking at the scope, I'm looking at like the thing on the side here. And I think that's it, guys. Or no, I think there's another faceless, actually. How many faces are there on these missions? This is getting ridiculous. Alright, how many shots is that? So this is the last guy, so... Whatever, stealth can handle this. Because he wouldn't have exposed himself if he wasn't the last guy. We also have a shield on, like, everybody, so... Just get out of here. Let's go home. Yes, we did, stealth.
Status confirmed. All hostiles are down and the area is secure. Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Well, that went pretty well. The nice thing is I have a nice aim bonus on stealth, you know? Because she's got the tracer round, so she's got the ability to... Like, that double shot, that negative 15 aim penalty is, like, actually more like negative 5. Figure is the best on her, you know? Still pretty good stuff. Although, very glitchy mission. I'm going to tell you guys that right now. Very odd mission. Oh, well, what are you going to do? Very long loading screen as well. I don't know, I was like, I started that, I'm like, I don't know, I'm gonna load because I don't know where that thing went, and then, like, I moved him into a slightly different position, and, like, the same thing happened for Adam. Like, it's just, he was in an odd spot, and where they can shoot through the... Now we know why they can shoot through the ceilings and walls and stuff. Because they hacked the Matrix, that's why. Oh well, lightly wounded. Honestly, I probably should have just reloaded that entire mission or something after that was happening, but whatever.
Oh, Commander.
What matters is Adam didn't die. Adam is shaken. After seeing the fucking ceilings disappear, I would be shaken too. Alright, so we got explosives going inside and a gate still going, so... and where were we leaving off? I think I was making a relay on Africa so I can trade out the, weapon things. And for 6 days, we get soldiered, no. More important than that, building the relays.
East African sector.
The good thing is we're making amazing strides on the Avatar project. Amazing strides.
Reading you loud and clear.
And we got lock and load, guys. So lock and load, I guess. And we're gonna make contact over here.
Setting course for Sector 7, Western Europe.
Might as well get Europe now. I mean, how many continents are there, or how many places are there in Europe? Apparently three. Or no, two. Sorry, that's not three.
Attempting to...
I hate to do this, but you're the only one who can pull this off. You know, I'd go myself if I could.
The gateway is primed. Is the subject prepared?
Ready. I hardwired what was left of the Codex brain into Rover. It should be emitting the same signal the Codex used to pass through the gateway.
Excellent. Let us begin. We've already seen the Codex opening a similar rift in the field. I am sure your device will be fine.
There. We're set to record across all spectrums.
Remember, go in, take some quick readings, then come right back through, okay? Whoa! Are you seeing this?
It appears our signal has been received. Increasing power!
Doesn't look like any place we've been before. Or any place on Earth, for that matter.
Perhaps this is the source. The aliens' seat of power, if you will. Secure beyond any physical limitations.
Only one way to find out.
Go on. We're counting on you.
Doctor.
The process did work. There was an instant where the device was in between locations. However, once that occurred, the gateway called for a second signature, an organic signature. When we could not provide one, it generated a sort of feedback pulse.
Obviously.
If the Codex creates the door, this organic signature must surely be the key.
Well, we better make sure we have the right key before we try again. I would hate for this to occur to something organic.
Agreed. I'll report our findings to the commander immediately.
No, bro, I've been watching the whole time. It's fine.
We are now prepared to autopsy the body of the powerful being we recovered, Commander. I feel that we may be on the cusp of attaining a complete understanding of this avatar we have long sought.
All right. Well, the gremlin is dead. Like, they tried to make that the cute thing, but honestly, it's ectopods. Alright, let's do the rest of these autopsies. Let's get the gatekeeper, shall we? That sounds
this
good.
This specimen, henceforth referred to as the gatekeeper, seems to harbor considerable psionic power.
As with the alien's other unique biomechanical field unit, it will take some time to decipher the systems involved in its function.
All right, that's fine.
Despite the unexpected outcome of our tests on the alien psionic gate, I firmly believe the experiment itself was absolutely critical to our future operations. We now understand exactly how the gateway functions and what will be required should we attempt to pass through. Still, I must admit, I do feel some regret over the damage done to Shen's gremlin, even if it is only a machine.
I actually didn't build this, apparently, for that last mission. As I said, it was a load. I might actually make a battle scanner. We have 59 supplies, though. Eh, sure, we'll make one. Because that seems like a nice thing for somebody to have, at least. Okay. So, I guess we're done here. Go back to making this thing. Making the world go round.
Power relay now operational.
Oh, there you go. Shen's legacy. I did this. I don't know why I did this. Carry on. We have one person free. Doesn't need to be on that because we have enough power for a crap ton of stuff. Apparently, I didn't even need to do anything with the resistance comms either because I think there's only enough space left for one more thing. So, man the turrets. All hands to battle stations. All right, let's go. All right, let's continue this thing. All right, Ken has now inspire. All right, continue training. What else can he get? Immune to fire, poison, acid, explosive, or he stuns a target. Let's stun a target, actually. I don't know, fire, poison, and acid, has that really ever been an issue for him? Not particularly, no. Alright, we got advanced explosives. What does that even do? It upgrades our grenades. Now I kind of regret selling them before. I think I just got a free upgrade for grenades. Temporarily shut down. Whatever. We have a ton of stuff anyway. Smoke bomb. There we go. Alright, all this is terrible. Alright, so now we have... we can get maybe an experimental heavy weapon or something. I don't want the armor. We need more heavy weapons, though. Or maybe experimental ammo. Let's go heavy weapon.
I'll let you know as soon as the project is ready for deployment.
We only have so many cores, you know. I mean, as soon as we take over Europe, I mean, those things are going to finish instantly, so... Oh, hey, it's the UK! Or something. Which looks strangely like Africa. Take that as you will.
Long live the resistance!
No, that's actually not the UK, that's like France. I guess that makes sense then. Because we're technically in France right now. Alright, I guess we only have one last place to actually check out. That would be here.
We've utilized all of our available communications capacity. We can't establish any new contacts until we upgrade our systems.
Does that even matter, though?
Attempting to establish local...
The outcome of this research can only further our advances, Commander. I have come to suspect that this creature's unusual appearance is somehow directly connected to its notable psionic aptitude. The aliens always have some reasoning to their actions, even as twisted as it is often revealed to be.
We got an alien psiamp now. Nice. Alright, let's do, I guess,
As initially speculated by Shen, it does in fact appear that this creature is restricted to the confines of its own hulking environmental suit. Unfortunately for our troops, the suit itself is a powerful physical threat, regardless of the operator's status, as we learned with some astonishment in the field.
Alright, we're doing that autopsy. That sounds pretty good. I guess we just continue now. Oh, we're gonna get our supply drop too soon, actually.
Alien facility coordinates locked in, Commander.
Where's the facility? I don't know. We don't really care about that, though, right now. My contact. Oh no, one blip, who cares?
Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
You have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
The Avatar project is only like three blips, so it doesn't matter. All right. So let's see. Aliens seek to overrun XCOM, placing extra chrysalids on each mission for much. Oh my god. No. I don't care what these are. I'm getting rid of that. That's the worst one. Ignore that for now. I want to just get this.
Commander, the aliens continue to make progress on the Avatar project. If we're going to slow them down, we'll need to move fast.
We don't care. Alright, let's see. Continue his training instead of stasis. Ah, here we go. If the Psy operative takes enough damage to be killed, they're immediately put in stasis for one turn and their health is only reduced to 1 HP. Oh, nice. Definitely gonna do that. Seeing as Kand ripped a couple times the last couple missions. Now he's invincible. Alright, we got this guy. And then we gotta get the supplies, and then I guess that's it then. I don't really care about the Avatar project anymore, because it's like, it's so low that I think we could just finish the game without it, but whatever. I'll do whatever I want with regards to that.
Signal's coming through clear.
And yeah, we're gonna do that. I think we're basically done. The only other thing we have to do is to do that, but we need supplies first.
Avengers plotting new course.
Need supplies before we can make the radio relay. And also, I think I can make that alien... I'm pretty sure I have to make that alien thing. It's not something I just upgrade randomly. There we go. Another flamethrower!
I do not think I could have predicted this outcome.
Though it is intriguing.
The fact that this armored environmental suit is capable of functioning in combat well after the original wearer has expired is... remarkable. I must consult with Shin for further study into this unusual behavior.
A proximity mine. That sounds terrible. That really does sound awful. Alright, last
this
one.
This fearsome creature, long referred to as a berserker, is clearly a genetic relation to the other mutant species we have encountered in the field. For reasons yet unknown, this particular variant is unique in that it is altogether consumed by what can only be described as blind rage, a thirst for combat, unlike any other creature we've encountered.
Neat. That's gonna be not a long time. It's gonna be 3 days. Alright, let's finish this thing up. Oh, come on, I don't wanna... One second, cancel that. How many, we got like half a day left on this thing. One sec. Let's just do this, okay. So before we continue on, because I don't want to go back there.
What can I do for you,
Waste
Commander?
Of time. Let's build items. So let's see what we got here. We got a ton of supplies, so here's our alien psyamp. One gatekeeper shell, 200 supplies, something, okay. Not a lot of money, to be honest. And the other thing we want is, apparently we could just make the EMP bomb whenever we want. Which is interesting. Oh. Yeah, we can do that, can't we? Let's make this, just because I want to troll you all. But do we not have an EMP bomb right now? Or maybe we don't. I was thinking to myself, I'm like, oh, do we have to, like... Because I thought it upgraded my old one, but apparently it didn't do that. Yeah, no, it... Where the hell is it, actually? Real talk, where did it go? We have to remake it or something? What happened here? That's weird. Okay, so maybe it didn't matter that I sold them, actually, now that I think about it. Yeah, there's like absolutely no EMP grenades at all. Because I know I didn't equip them on anybody. So it just got rid of them for me. It's like, yeah, you don't need that shit no more. Or maybe I consumed it? I don't know. Don't ask me, this game's wonky. Sketchy. Alright, so I'm gonna just quick save here. And the reason why, you ask, is because I'm gonna just do this, skip it. And then we got the rest of the supply drop. Alright, let's go to West Asia.
Setting course for Sector 15, West Asia.
Because, I mean, it was so close to being done, I don't think they're gonna complain. That could be one of those minute things, is it? But this mission will be for next time, guys, so remember, we'll be watching. Take care.